Hi, this is Rich, and I understand that he's got a little bit more to say about the Fulham UFO predictions and first contact and all that sort of thing, okay? So, Rich, what's the deal? You didn't like the Fulham thing? You weren't buying into the whole wonderful prediction thing? What's that about? Well, okay, there's a few things I want to make clear. There's so much to say on this subject. UFOs and first contact and sightings. We've been having sightings for years and years and years. It's just, you know, and I'm not saying that there are not legitimate sightings. I'm just saying, well, there's a lot of things I'm saying. But one is, if you do a YouTube search, you search UFO Yaweh. That's Y-A-H-W-E-H. And there's this guy. Now, I don't really subscribe to all his story necessarily. It's not about his story and why he can do what he does. But what he can do, he can way predict these sightings, similar to what Fulham predicted. And he can do it in the moment. He stood there, and you'll see it on the video. He stands there, he says he's going to call forth a UFO. And he calls the news media. The news media comes. They don't believe him. They get out there with their cameras. They're waiting. Sure enough, this guy brings the UFO in the sky. And so I watched this a few years ago, and this Yawweh guy has done this many, many times, many times. So it's a no-brainer for a guy like Yawweh to bring these things forth, right? And here's my theory. Back then, when that was happening, it got covered by the news, but you didn't see a lot of you don't see it on CNN, and you don't see a lot of business going on, and a lot of activity, and a lot of buzz about any of this. And so now we're getting a big buzz on a guy, Fulham, is predicted something similar. No, he predicted a big thing, right? And so we in Manhattan, same little bitty floaty thing in the sky. And I'm going, wow, that's lame. You know, I don't know how he did it, but if he can do it like Yawweh guy does it, this is not what we saw with the camera. And we're assuming that that wasn't faked camera work. You know, we're kind of beyond that. Let's just assume that wasn't fake camera work. Whatever was up there, we saw it. Now, was it a holographic projection? We don't know. We'll never know. Was it an extraterrestrial advanced race? We don't know, and we never will. Was it a holographic projection, ET race, aliens? Is it some other wild and crazy thing? A person like me is probably never going to know, not in this lifetime, in this body. Okay, so I'm just looking at that and going, okay, what I'm seeing here is a media hype on this thing. And I am all for first contact with the good ETs. But see, I think first contact with benevolent good ETs has already occurred. So anything about first contact is, in my world, nonsense. First contact has been made to the significant government bodies in the world. Some of them, anyway. And so that's out. So now we're talking full disclosure. Well, I think the only way that the New World Order gang, the shadow government, would want to do a full disclosure would be, one, a lie, because they simply can't tell the truth. Alex Collier brought up some really good points that if the governments were to bring up the truth of whether full disclosure, whether it was way back when they really had first contact, or if the governments decided to tell a story and say they just made contact, the thing is they could not tell the truth about what's going on, about the advanced technologies, and it just so many things would come out. It's That's another really long story. And that's another reason I wanted to share this video is because things are so involved. This is no little short subject, right? We're talking about major things. Either one. First contact, big thing. UFO cover-up, big thing. Oh, man, I get, what I do is I get wound up and I get pissed off and I get angry and I got all this energy and some, it's exciting energy and it's just like, oh, man. I'm just saying, look, we've got first contact. First contact isn't the same thing as full disclosure. Full disclosure is not the same thing as somebody predicting UFO sightings. And none of those three are the same things as mass sightings in the sky. So these are three different phenomena. They're all jumbled together, and I believe that the dark side gang is playing all this stuff, and they're trying to get the masses to buy into a fake something. Second coming, mass sightings. And now, I'm not saying that I wouldn't like to see mass sightings over all the major cities to wake up the world. You know, I've often thought of that scenario. That's the way to do it, man. But I was thinking better yet, drop flyers, you know. but here's the thing. In the middle of a play where the New World Order dark side is trying to pull a fast one with fakery and lies and deception, I wouldn't want a real UFO presence to show up. And I know that these extraterrestrials, the friendlies, they are all over. They know exactly what the shadow governments are up to and what they're about and how they're playing things. And they know it better than most of us, if not all of us. So they wouldn't be pulling off a mass sighting thing with a bunch of little white dots in the sky in the same time frame that our shadow governments or the dark side is trying to pull off a deception with the holographic fakery and stuff. They just wouldn't do that, in my opinion. So that said, it's kind of like the confusion. There was 9/11 inside job, right? The day that the 9/11 attack occurred, NORAD, run by Dick Cheney, was doing a simulation attack, terrorist attack, on the World Trade Center. Now, that's too coincidental for me, man. That is not a coincidence. That's part of the whole inside job. There's massive amounts of information that the 9/11 attack was an inside job. The terrorists were not the terrorists that they're telling us it was. Totally not. Inside job. So that was a case of creating a massive deception while a real phenomena was occurring. Totally causes confusion. So I'm just saying the friendly ETs would not be doing flyovers and parking it over the major cities or making themselves known in that way during the same time period that it's all over the place that the on the net that the shadow government New World Order gang is considering fake first contact, fake mass sightings and stuff. So you got to ask yourself, why is that whole subject getting so much press right now? And a guy like Fulham's prediction, which fell flat on his face, one little thing up in the sky in Manhattan was all we got. Now you can spin more stories about all that, but that's all we got. And then I show you this guy just YouTube the phrase UFO Yaweh, and you will see this guy. he's got way more credibility and predictability and track record than Fulham had. And so we're not getting any oomph behind that one. There's no mass push to get the buzz going on the internet about that. So it's just all very, very, very suspicious to me. And I'm saying don't buy it. Now, and I'm not saying no such thing as mass sightings or that will or won't occur. That's a whole different subject to discuss, and the pros and cons of that. And I would like to see the friendlies show up and throw in and help too. I haven't got it worked out what would be the best way for that to happen, but I sure know it would be a bad time right now. Timing is everything right about now, I think. So anyway, that's my message. Another cheesy, not well thought out message. Just the stuff I got in my I wanted to get it out there and get it set. So you guys can agree, whatever. The point being that there's so much information out there contrary that UFO people alone are disagreeing with the facts. And the same with the New World Order people thinking this, and the reptilians that, and the ETs and all this stuff, and 2012. There's all this conflicting information, so we all have to process it out. And I'm just saying it's a good idea to, put the stuff out on the table and let people process it and come up with their own conclusion. And so I want to do my part in helping people see and step back and look at all things before drawing any hasty conclusions that are limiting. I believe that the best conclusions drawn will be those that are most freeing and make you feel best. It's just a suspicion I have. Okay. Hey, better run. Talk to you later. Hey, and thanks for letting me yap it up. You're welcome. We're out of here. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.